Hey guys, it's your friend Kat here. Today we are going to do a makeup transformation that is super intense, creepy, with a big mouth of No Face. This is a spirit from the movie Spirited Away. If you have not seen this movie by the famous Hayao Miyazaki, it is a Japanese animated film that is one of my all-time favorite movies. I know I say a lot of things are my favorite, but honestly, this is my top three. There's so much meaning behind this movie, and it looks like a child's animation. It's all hand done. It's beautiful, the storyline is amazing. It's deep and dark, has so many layers, and teaches you so many things about a little girl who gets lost in a different land. But I don't want to give away too much. One of the most mysterious characters in this movie that is one of my favorites is No Face. He starts off being something that's kind of like an evil spirit, but then he changes his ways. When No Face has his evil side, he has this really big mouth on his chest, so I decided to paint it today. You should really check out the movie if you have not seen it. But let's turn to No Face today and get started with the video. First of all, we are going to start off by blocking our eyebrows, putting on layers of glue stick and powder to flatten our eyebrows down so that we can paint on top of them, doing 2 to 3 to 4 layers of glue stick and powder, depending on how thick your eyebrow hairs are. And no, I am not naked in this video. I do have a tube top on because I am going to do a body painting of No Face's huge mouth later. But once we have our eyebrows completely flattened down, I'm gonna get some liquid latex. Putting that liquid latex across my cheeks and on my nose and letting it dry. Then I'm gonna get some tape. Make sure that you are not allergic to the adhesive on tape if you're going to do this. That's why I decided to put a layer of liquid latex just in case I have any reactions, you never know. And it helps the tape adhere better onto your skin. These layers of tape on our face over the layer of liquid latex is gonna help our nose completely flatten down since No Face has no nose whatsoever. It kinda looks like he has a white masked face. Then I'm gonna get more liquid latex with a red stipple sponge and stipple the edges of the tape to my skin. And I'm gonna stipple liquid latex, of course, as you can see, all over the tape as well, not just the edges. I did about 7 layers or more of this, but you guys don't want to see that, me doing this 7 times. Letting it dry with a hair dryer. So once that is all completely dried of the tape and liquid latex layers, we're gonna get a white eyeliner pencil. Because now it is time to outline No Face's features. Even though he's called No Face, he does have features on his face. He has a slender face that is a lot more thinner than mine is, so I'm drawing that. His eyes on my eyelids when I close my eyes, and he has these purplish triangle marks above the eyebrows and below his eyelids as well. He also has these little slits of purple right above the lower portion of the cheek and on our chin. You really want to look at reference pictures of No Face from Spirited Away if you're doing this makeup. Now it is time to grab some white cream paint. This is from Bednai, but any white cream paint will do. And I'm just gonna fill in the white parts of his face, even going over the outlines we did. We just put that there to see roughly where the proportions of his facial features would be. You definitely wanna put it over the taped liquid latex parts of our nose and face, leaving No Face's eyes on our eyelids completely bare and whitening in the other parts of our face that we did within the oval of No Face's drawn on face. Once we have all the areas completely white, we are gonna powder it down with some translucent powder before getting a white aqua paint. This is really gonna make sure our whites are crisp, pure white, and that there's no colors of the tape showing through or our skin tone. Drying that down with a blow dryer to make sure it's completely dry before getting some black aqua paint or black cream paint and painting in No Face's eyes on our eyelids. The areas that we left bare, just like he has in the movie, they remind me the charcoal parts of a snowman's face where a snowman's eyes are, but they are wider and more like a slit instead of a round eye. I'm also getting a black liquid eyeliner to perfect the edges of his eye, making sure they're crisp and not too sloppy. I'll also use the black aqua paint to paint in No Face's mouth on my lip as well, right below where the tape and liquid latex would have been. Then I got this purple lavender colored NYX liquid eyeliner and started drawing in the purple details of No Face's facial features. If you're a fan of Hayao Miyazaki's Spirited Away, you remember these facial features and they kind of remind me of the other facial paintings in the movie Princess Mononoke that Hayao Miyazaki has also made. Honestly, all of Hayao Miyazaki's movies are absolutely amazing, but they are more suitable for audiences that are teenagers and above. But as we are painting in these purple shapes on our face, that kind of reminds me of candy, we are gonna get some white aqua paint in, just sharpen the edges of the purple shapes, making sure they are clean. And don't forget to put a purple shape on your chin as well. Now it is time to get a mixture of a gray tone and black matte eyeshadow and put that over the purple features on the face. No face's features that are the purple shapes are more muted. They're not as much of a lavender bright purple, so that's what we are trying to achieve here. And once you're done with that, we are gonna get some black aqua paint and start painting around the white face that No Face has. It almost looks like in the movie he's wearing a black coat. So that's what we're trying to achieve with this black aqua paint. And don't forget to paint in your ears as well. If you don't want to deal with all this paint, you could definitely just wear a black Scream coat from the movie Scream. Something like that, that's like a cloak with a hood, and just paint this on your face. But we're gonna do a body painting of the mouth as well. And it fades nicely into the black background. We are also painting our neck. And then once you have the collar of your neck painted, we are going to dry it down with the blow dryer. Because again, this is some aqua paint. We don't want it to crease as much. Now I'm getting the white eyeliner pencil again and drawing the feature of the huge mouth that No Face has in the beginning of the movie, where he's an evil spirit that consumes everything in his path. So you really want to look at pictures from the movie as well to do this, because it has teeth and spit and a huge tongue. Once we are done drawing the outline of the mouth, I'm gonna get some either red lipstick or red cream paint and painting his tongue and his gums as well. I switch between red and maroon. Maroon has a little bit of a brown tone red in it. Using that maroon color on the inside of his mouth, not just on his gums and tongue, around the teeth, and then I get some black cream paint and paint the inside of his throat, right by his tongue, and shade in near his gums, between his gums and his tongue. Once you have enough shading on the tongue and inside of his throat, we're gonna get some translucent powder to powder that down. Getting some black matte eyeshadow to do the detail of some more shadows. Now it's time to switch to that black aqua paint again. If you have a long V-neck shirt or like a black jacket or a hoodie, you could definitely use that instead of painting your whole body like I am here. My favorite black paint that is hard to get off because it has wax substance in it is Wolf Brothers, because it's so pigmented. Graftobian also makes a great aqua paint, but any black aqua paint will do, or like I said, just use a hoodie or clothing that doesn't cover the mouth if you're painting on the mouth. Honestly, if they sold t-shirts with this mouth drawing on it, I would buy it. But once you have enough of the black paint on, we're gonna dry it completely down with the hairdryer and get some white cream paint with an angled brush to do the detail and color in all of No Face's teeth. They remind me of Trident gum. The reason why I use white paint last is because I don't want to smear any of the red or black paints into the white to make it more muddy. I want the white teeth to stand out. Once all the teeth are colored in, I'm gonna let that dry and get some black aqua paint with a very thin brush or an eyeliner and outline his teeth. This is gonna give it so much more detail and make the teeth stand out and his whole entire mouth just pop. Now I'm just getting that matte gray eyeshadow again and toning down the lavender parts of No Face's face. And once you're done with that, we are completely done with this No Face makeup transformation from the movie Spirited Away during his scariest moments in the beginning of the movie when he was attacking people and more of an evil spirit. I hope you guys enjoyed this makeup transformation. Leave me a comment down below on what other makeups you would love to see. I am doing holiday themed makeups coming up in December and I cannot wait to do those. But now it's time for me to transform back into myself. Make sure if you did this liquid latex tape thing on your face, you do not rip it off. Make sure you get some makeup remover with it. I'm using isopropyl myristate, which is the perfect best makeup remover for any type of effects makeup. Really soaking down my powder puff with the isopropyl myristate to make sure it gets all the makeup off. This will make it so that I will less likely tear at my skin, the top layers of my skin, because that could happen and I could damage my skin if I don't use the right makeup removers. But thank you guys so much for watching and hanging out with me today. If you do this makeup or any makeup from my YouTube channel, please post it on your Instagram accounts and tag me #catsketch, because I would love to see it. Subscribe for more makeups like this and other makeup transformations in the future on this channel. I cannot wait to show you so many things coming up. Thanks guys again for all the support. All the products I used in this video will be listed down below in the description box. And I will see you guys in the next video. Love y'all. Bye.